We all grew up watching the Pepsi Super Bowl halftime show. A moment as big as the Super Bowl itself. That edge of your seat feeling is exactly what I'm aiming for. From a small local venue in Toronto to the world stage, I'm continuing this journey with my fans, taking them into the next chapter of our story. As your 55th Pepsi Super Bowl halftime show performer.
Not a lot of people understand the amount of work that goes into these sort of things. Sell people on a dream and then figure out how to make it happen. I was inspired by Roy Anderson and how he creates illusions and forced perspective.
I looked at a treatment and he had like a nice like little sketch. From there we started to like talk about like what are iconic moments of Vegas and like what tells you Vegas.
We started kind of constructing it piece by piece, knowing where the camera had to be, how high it had to be, the exposure, the stop, the focus, the layout, the depth of field. Each piece had to be to the centimeter perfect for the effect to work.
Without all these pre-vis softwares, we wouldn't have been able to figure out like scale. Because as you move a piece that's in the background, you have to maintain its scale in the final image. So it was really an insane process to get to this point.
And they did it. They actually did it. It took a lot of key players involved to make this thing happen.
The amount of people who worked on this set from art department would probably be about 180. Everybody really went the extra mile because I think everybody knew that it was going to be this like amazing piece that you build, you know?
It's been inspiring to watch everyone work so hard and so carefully to make this whole thing come to life.
Stand by the rules.
I think that this will set a new bar for future shows to come.
All right, that's a wrap.
That's a wrap on HBS, everybody. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Everybody, I'm Bruce Rogers. I'm excited to show you the behind the scenes of this gigantic set design. Follow me. This is the first time in 55 years that we are not putting a show out on the football field, and we wanted to do something super, super cool. So we're gonna go up the different tiers of this platform in and around the path that all the dancers use. Over here, we've got these special hooks that hold on to wardrobe. Every dancer has a number and a special lighting device. They're all kind of hidden behind these facades. Let's keep going. So there are tricks in design that make scenery read perfectly on camera. So what you're seeing here is a lot of gray tones and accented light in the backlit plexi, but it's designed this way so that at a distance it pops and looks dimensional. We're walking up to tier 6, and we'll finally be able to get to Abel's platform at the end of this journey. Follow me. We're now standing about 60 feet above the grass. It's probably the highest platform of any halftime show. And at this moment, you saw a big pyro fireworks display behind Abel, and this is where we capture that shot. This set is designed to hold 75 choir members, 256 dancers, Abel, a band, a string orchestra, which is a lot of people. Now I want to take you to my favorite part that's hidden underneath the stage. It's called the Infinity Room. If this is not a backstage look, I don't know what is. When we got these sketches from Ez, we were like, wow, that's a lot of light bulbs. Come on in and check it out. There are 7,000 light bulbs built into the design. Not only the ones that are exposed, but all the ones behind these infinity mirrors. Abel, as you saw, is joined by 20 dancers that create this surreal cacophony of movement to help him disguise his way out of the room and head that way to go up the stairs for his hero position. What I want to show you right now is Abel's starting position when he's first revealed. The set design splits, and the whole world sees him the first time, and he walks forward. He'll follow me. This is what he does. I'm not quite Abel, but I know how to show him how to walk. Pretty cool.
The audience just doesn't really understand the mechanics of us splitting this open. Because when you add all of this structure, we're about 80,000 pounds that we're splitting.
So a major piece of machinery.
That would be something that the audience might go, oh, it opened up.
I think one of the great things in my heart about what we've created here is the fact that we combined 3 set shops to build one set design. We've never done that before. Our industry has been really hurt. So a lot of those people that would help us get the show out on the field are home right now watching. We love you. We miss you. And this one's for you. That's it, everybody. Hope you enjoyed this tour and a look behind the scenes.